Good afternoon students. So today we are going to learn one of the most important relation in your dielectric, that is Clausius-Mossotti equation. What is Clausius-Mossotti equation? So it is given by this equation. N is number of dipoles per unit volume. Alpha E is known as your polarizability constant. 3 constant. Epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. This ER is known as your relative permittivity, okay? So this is N alpha E 3 epsilon naught is equals to relative permittivity minus 1 divided by relative permittivity plus 2. So this equation is known as your Clausius-Mossotti equation. So how this equation comes? This comes to the this constructive arrangement, or you can say that first upon you have to calculate the electric field. Okay, what is the electric field due to the any dielectric material? Actually this electric field is a sum of external electric field plus electric field due to this polarized dielectric material. Okay, plus you take E1 also. E1 means electric field. Suppose we have to find out the electric field at this point. So this point electric field will be the sum of external electric field due to this dielectric material, which is to be a polarized, or due to its polarization, electric field due to the charges induced on its surface of the dielectric. And if I have to find out the electric field at this point, then I have to consider a spherical cavity. Okay, so then charges are induced on the surface of this spherical cavity. So E1 is known as your electric field due to the charges induced on the surface of this spherical cavity, plus E2 is also there. E2 means electric field due to the dipole inside that spherical cavity. Actually this spherical cavity is of atomic dimension. Atomic dimension means this should be of 10 to the power minus 10 meter dimension. So it is a very small. So these dipoles inside this spherical cavity are very small. That's why E2 is nearly equals to the 0. You can neglect E2 also. And this term E0 and E1, this is known as your local electric field. Electric field due to the electric field experienced by the molecules present in the dielectric material. That electric field is known as your local electric field. E local, you can say that. Okay. So plus this value E plus E1 is there. Okay, you can take this total electric field, or this is your local electric field. Sorry, this is your local electric field. This is your net electric field. Okay, this is net electric field means it is a sum of external electric field plus electric field due to the polarization that we have discussed in previous lecture. So this is your net electric field. So net electric field is denoted by E. Here I have taken E dash. This is for electric field due to the polarization. So this I have to first calculate electric field. Okay, then from this electric field I have to find out the polarization. Okay, what is polarization? Polarization is a polarizability constant into the local electric field. Okay, and this local, if I have to substitute this local electric field here, this will be gives you the polarization. Okay, yeah, and from this, if you substitute this value, then you will arrange this equation. Okay, and you will get this equation. Okay. So in this equation, this is the basic idea regarding your Clausius-Mossotti equation. What is Clausius-Mossotti equation? This one is your Clausius-Mossotti equation. And how will you get this equation? You have to start from this. First of all, you have to calculate the local electric field. So this local electric field means electric field experienced by the molecule present in the dielectric material. That is known as your local electric field, and which is the sum of E0, E dash, E1 and E2. But E0 plus E dash, this is known as your net electric field. So I have taken it as a E. And plus E1. What is E1 here? E1 is the electric field experienced by the charges inside the electric field experienced due to the charges on the surface cavity, surface of this spherical cavity. And this spherical cavity is of atomic dimension. So we have taken E1 here. And we have taken E2 is equals to 0. What is E2 here? E2 is the electric field due to the dipoles which are present inside the that spherical cavity. But there are very small number of dipoles present because it is of atomic dimension. So that's why we have taken E2 is equals to 0. Or if there are dipoles present on one side, same dipoles will be present on the other side. So due to its symmetry, this value is also equals to 0. So that's why we have taken E2 is equals to 0. If you substitute this, you will get E local is equals to E net electrical field plus E1. Then first of all, what we have to do? We have to find out the value of E1. Then you have to substitute this value here. Then you will get local electric field. After getting this E local, you have to substitute this value in the polarization. What is polarization? Polarization or induced dipole moment. What is induced dipole moment? It is the proportional to the local electric field. Proportionality means this constant is known as your polarizability constant, alpha E. Okay. And if there are n number of molecules per unit volume, then this will be equals to your induced dipole moment. So this induced dipole moment is equals to n alpha E into the localized field, E local. So if you substitute, what is n here? N is the number of atoms or molecules per unit volume in this dielectric material. So if you substitute all these values and rearrange this equation, you will get this Clausius-Mossetti equation. So this is about your general idea. What is local electric field? And this is your local electric field. What is local electric field? Local electric field means electric field experienced by the molecules present in the dielectric, and it is given by, in terms of induced polarization, P induced polarization is equals to alpha E into local. So this induced polarization per unit volume known as your polarization vector. Okay, so P is equals to alpha E. If there are n number of molecules per unit volume, this then what there will be the polarization vector. P is equals to n alpha E into the local electric field. Okay, so in next lecture we will go for how to obtain this expression. We will start from that. Okay, thank you.